You got both what?
Big videos. I'm watching Friday right now, and like that song came out, the first one. Uh-huh. And I ain't gonna lie, bro. I got some shit to talk about.
You got inspired by Friday?
I did, man. You know that movie's like mad old and whatnot.
Yeah.
But there's something, you know. But we'll get to it. We'll get to it. I got some smoke. Well, not really smoke, but I got like a
observation.
Yeah. Like I was like, okay, like that should actually make some sense.
I feel like you got some energy in you, bro. What's going on?
Where I leave my phone at, man? Where's my phone at? I don't got it on me. Hold up.
You lost it.
Here it is. Here it's Charlie. All right, man. But you know, before we get to that shiznay, how are you doing, man? Haven't seen you in quite some time,
yeah,
my guy.
Yeah, it's been a minute, bro.
How you been?
It's good, bro. You know, laziness, whackness, missing the gym, crazy enough.
Okay. Yeah. You look slim. I'm not gonna lie. You look a little.
I look super slim. Like, yeah. I like it.
But like, it's lean. But yeah, you are looking a lot more slimmer.
Yeah, and I got that like 3 times this week. I was like, dude, I've only missed twice. Like,
yeah.
I've been like, I missed like 3 weeks in a row, actually, to be honest.
You haven't got zero gym time.
I went to the gym and I did obviously some workouts at home, but it's not the same thing because I don't have as much weight at home.
Right.
Like, you know, last week, the week before, this week I didn't do jack. Yeah. It's just, you know, like, so, like every time that I'm like, you know what, today I don't feel like going to the gym, I have a good reason why I don't feel guilty enough to skip the gym, you know, because I have something to do. But still, bro, I need to hit the gym.
Got you. Okay, that's good, man. I mean, you're looking slim, though, but you're wearing black, so, you know.
So that's
you're wearing jeans, you got a haircut.
I'm curving out my,
you know,
my figure.
It's a little changer, you know.
I'm curving out my figure a little bit.
Well, that's good. I mean, you don't got shorts on. So we're the opposite today. I'm in shorts and a t-shirt. You actually like, you know, what'd you do today, bro? You was out here in these streets again?
Coffee shops? Nah, I went, I got coffee, then I went home, you know, watched some football.
Okay.
Then I made coffee at home, you know.
Okay.
So I'm trying to be more cost efficient.
That's good, man. That's good. I'll tell you, you live a good life.
Because I make my own coffee now?
Yes.
Nah.
You making pilon?
Nah.
What are you making?
I'm making the little espresso shots.
So what coffee are you using? You using like some like natural Wynwood bar coffee or something?
No. I got somebody brought me actually a bag of coffee roasts from Costa Rica. Like, apparently Costa Rica is blowing up in coffee market for some reason.
Well, the guy from Costa Rica who came to visit us, he gave all of us some chocolate and coffee.
Oh, yeah,
coffee
I've had those. Those are great.
Really? They're not bad. I just don't like them that much.
Because you don't like coffee.
Yeah, it's like, oh, like once somebody gets that chocolate.
I know what you're talking about. Because people bring it to us from Central America all the time.
Yeah.
So sure. Costa Rica specifically.
But does it actually taste good though? Like, the coffee's actually good?
Yeah. You got to bite the bean.
Ugh. Well, I mean, I did bite the bean though, but it's, I don't know, it's not my thing, man.
Yeah, because you don't like coffee.
Well, the good thing is I didn't know you could bite the bean until I got to that point. I was like, okay, you could actually like get to this point. So I was like, okay, that's cool. I mean,
culture. But Costa Rica for some reason is getting famous about coffee. Who knows, man. So how's life, bro? How's that girl you're seeing?
What girl? Hey, let me tell you something, bro. You know, I like that you brought that up now, cause it's been interesting the past couple of weeks for me, right? So you know, these past couple of weeks I've been laying low, right? Like, well, I mean, I've been laying low for a while now, but I've been getting kind of like some like DM slides.
What's up, big head?
Yeah, like those kind of. Like, I'm like, okay, that's interesting to see. You know, some little things come to fruition here and there, you know what I'm saying? It's a good ego boost every now and then. It's like, okay, like,
I still got it.
You know, like when you're in high school, it's like you feeling some girl, and before you even hit on her, she comes and hits on you, and you kind of feel
like,
okay,
your chest come
out. Yeah, you start feeling like, okay.
Your voice gets deeper, you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, I had a scare yesterday. So, you know, I'm in the, so I go to movies yesterday, right? And my mom hits me up, she's like, yo, they're selling a house here, right? Like, yo, look into it and buy it, right? I'm like, I'm thinking this. I'm like, hold up. Like, what's going on here? Like, is my mom trying to kick me? I'm thinking my parents trying to kick me out the house because, you know, they're slowly trying to, like, cut me off. So my dad goes, yo, I'm taking you off of my insurance. Can you get your own work insurance, right? So I'm like, all right, that's cool, you know? And before that, he kind of asked me for some money. So I'm like, you know, those things aren't bad things, but it's almost weird, I guess, for me because it's like I'm not used to it. So it's like, okay.
It's a transition, like.
Right. But, which is fine. It's not a problem. But then my mom's like, oh, you should try to buy the house. You know, I always got to confine in my little sister because my little sister knows all the tea.
So you're like, yo.
So I go, yo, so I'm going to kick out the house. She's like, no, bro. She just wants you like to, like, you know, get a crib, you know, start making money and stuff. And I'm like, well, more money in that sense. Right? I'm not a complete bum. Not yet. So I'm like, oh, okay, it makes sense. So I kind of have to go into the explanation. Mm-hmm. Like, look, the first home I buy, I want it to be multifamily, right? Mm-hmm. Multifamily so is like, you know,
duplex.
Right, like a duplex, a triplex, or like, you know, it could be like a unit that has like three, four apartments. So it makes sense. Yeah, I mean, you live in one place because, you know, the first, right, the first property that you live in, the first property you buy, you have to live in it, right? For like at least a year, you know, or you could finesse some things here and there. But I mean, for the most part, that's what you have to do, right? So I was like, you know, it's in that sense of investing, that's the best thing to do in that
sense. Yeah, because you still got to live by it.
Yeah, exactly. So I'm like, you know, buying a place here, it's like, nah, it's not the best thing just because, you know, I would have to live there. Like, or I could do the finesse thing where it's like, oh, I could stay here, but have all my mail go over there. Yeah. But that's kind of messy. And then, like you know, this place is like one family type thing. So, like, it's not going to really produce too much income. And it's, like, already
pretty expensive. Yeah, but you can do, like Airbnb or something like that.
Yeah, but who wants to do Airbnb here? Like, nobody does Airbnb in the hood like
First
that.
First of all.
Nah, man. Do people do Airbnb?
You're posting. This will be your posting. Airbnb 3-2 Miami / Wynwood.
Well, again, right, you gotta market it right.
5 minutes away from all the parties.
Yeah. Well, I mean, maybe. You're right. I mean, I don't know. I feel like, you know, Miami has this this thing, right? Where it's like the popular. So if you're not from Miami, I think the popular thing is always the beach. So you're thinking, oh, I'm gonna get a condo or some shit like that at the beach, right? Like, you know, it's, I don't know. I think that it's kind of hard to do Airbnb here in the hood. You don't think so? You think it'll be easier to do Airbnb in the townhouse?
Right.
And the question will be, how often would that be filled though?
Yeah, that's true.
Because then, well, if you have a mortgage on it, I mean,
yeah, you better get some.
You have to have somebody there every month. You get what I'm saying? That's kind of like, that's gonna be a little bit like hard to.
Yeah,
like,
you gotta
at least for my first property, I don't have that experience yet. So I mean, yeah, I think that's kind of like. Yeah, a hard thing to like to.
So
to
you're getting kicked out, is what you're saying.
Well, no. I thought I was, but apparently I'm not. But I'm glad that I got that scared because now I was like, okay, you know what? I gotta get more of my shit together. Yeah, I mean, even I feel like, you know, I'm doing like somewhat of a good job, but then, you know, there's months where it's like, nah, you know. It made me feel like, okay, bro, it's time to get your shit together. ASAP, motherfucker. Cause you don't know when
it's gonna go down.
That's like That's like getting any kind of wake-up call. You get what I'm saying? It's like, yo, my nigga, like, look, you're good, but get your ass up and get popping.
You can be better. You can be better.
Exactly. Yeah. You get me? So, kind of like that happened. Hopefully, you know, that sets me up, you know, like, that down the line to be a little bit more strict. I mean, you've been doing a good job so far. Like, you have not been really going out like that.
I'm behaving, bro.
Yeah, you've been. So, what would you credit that to? You think you credit it to the Xbox?
I credit it to three things.
Okay.
Being fed up with Miami traffic, I am tired. I am so tired of driving. Like, you know, like, yo, like, if I had the funds, I would hire a driver. Like, that's how tired I am of driving.
Have you done the math yet or no? Or yeah, like, you haven't tried to see, like,
nah, first of all, ain't nobody gonna, bro, Airbnb, Uber would be expensive. Yeah. Like, the public transportation in this city is trash.
Yeah, yeah.
You get me? Like, a lot of other cities that have a lot of traffic at least have reliable public transportation.
Right.
Our public transportation is trash.
Right.
It's so bad.
You mean like a New York?
Yeah, exactly. You have a subway system that is continually running, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
Washington, D.C. has like a subway station with like trains that go five different directions. Okay. You know, so our city in L.A. are some of the worst public transportations we have.
Yeah, I heard L.A. is pretty
bad. That doesn't work. I don't credit to Xbox. I think Xbox is a good excuse to stay home.
Like a distractor, you mean?
Yeah, you know, I don't feel like I need to go out or do any of that. I just think it's like I got into that point where I'm really, really just tired of going out. Like, I feel like everything's repetitive.
Got you.
You get what I'm saying? I told you. And for me, it's always about finding a new thing.
Yeah.
Like, I find a new restaurant to eat or a new coffee spot. Like, that's what I usually, if you think about it, even when on Saturdays or Sundays. Yeah. I'll tell you, let's go to that specific spot.
Yeah.
We come back and record, and then we either chill, watch a movie, or I go home and sleep.
Right.
Like, that is literally it. I don't want to be out anymore. Yeah, right, I just want to.
You just want to be homebody. Yeah.
Like,
chill.
I like coffee spots, you know, but even then, I also want to have the balance of how coffee at home. So, I'm looking at a different roast. I'm looking at different procedures. I'm trying to learn how to make good coffee on my own.
Yeah.
So, I know, like, that idea of trying to just kind of, like, chill,
mellow down.
Because I feel like if we're not careful, our pace gets too fast.
Yeah,
and I've been feeling like I've been burning out a little bit.
Okay,
because I got a lot of stuff going on. Like Monday,
yeah,
I work, but it's also like I got after work activities. Like I even feel like lately I've been sucking at self care in the physical aspect.
Yeah,
you know, because since I've been so busy with so many other things, I gave myself the excuse of you can afford the rest.
Right.
But I should kill my body a little bit more and push it to that physical gym aspect, you know.
Right.
So I've been thinking that maybe I should get two gym memberships. You know, get the Y.
Yeah.
and also get like a Planet Fitness for like $10. So, because there's a Planet Fitness right by the house. So whenever I'm, for whatever, you know, logistical sense, there's no space or time that I can be down here, I can be up there and at least get a workout.
Yeah.
Because I'm realizing that I'm wasting a lot of time driving, and sometimes it's not wasted in the sense that I'm thinking about different things, processing different things, but sometimes it's just wasted because by the time I get home or anywhere else, I'm drained.
Right. I mean,
and I feel like that is what's going on.
And you've been on that like schedule for a while now, right? Like you've been like it's like, you know, you got work and then you usually have like an activity like damn near like every other day type of stuff, right?
So I've been feeling like lately life is going fast.
Yeah.
And so coffee is always for me, that the people don't get it, but for me coffee is not like Instagram coffee, but this girl is like, you guys don't drink coffee, I'm sorry. If you gotta add a bunch of sugar to your coffee, you guys have... It's like when somebody gets a cocktail, but they like put a bunch of stuff so they don't actually even taste the alcohol.
Yeah, I got you.
It's like, you don't like to drink, so stop drinking, you know?
Yeah.
You don't like coffee, stop drinking coffee.
Yeah.
Drink a tea that's herbal, that's nice. You know, but if you like coffee, for me, coffee is just like a refresh. I always told you, it's a reset. I think for me that... has to be lately. I've been listening to my body like, yo, you need to just chill. It's going too fast.
Coffee to you is like somebody's nap, or it's like somebody's you know, like I guess like sport here and there. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, it's like, you know, that thing that kind of gets you back into like motion.
Exactly. So like I'll either sit down with the homies, right, like you, me, and Fatima, and sit down in a coffee shop, and that's usually when I reflect and I'm like, you know, my life feels fast, but God is still good.
Gotcha. Right.
Or like today's like today that you know, we bought pizza. We just went to the house watching game. I just made my own coffee cup, like one of those little espresso shots.
Yeah.
And I sat down and I kept watching the game, and it was just like, okay, you know, take a deep breath, bro.
So how are you taking that in now? Like, you're saying like you feel like your life is moving fast. How are you dealing with that though? Like, in slowing it down, like, what's your process there?
I think it's a lot of times I ask myself, and obviously faith is a thing that's obvious to me. I think you guys know that already. I ask God like, hey, how am I doing? You know, like, I have patterns. I think a lot of us have disciplines and schedules that those are essential. Mm-hmm. But there also has to be a point where your schedule has to stop if it's becoming more about the schedule and less about the spirit part. You know, like, less about how I'm doing inside. Because there's going to be a point I'm going to run dry and I won't be able to give nobody anything. Mm-hmm. So I always constantly ask myself, like, yo, how you feeling, bro? Like, how you feeling? Like, you know? And so there's days that I'm just like, I'm not even gonna hit up George today because I don't want to hit leg day. I just need to go home and sleep.
Yeah.
And there's days that I'll go to sleep like at 9 p.m. Mm-hmm. You know, because I've been feeling like, you know, and if you know this, your body does not get rest in one day.
Yeah.
Your body gets rest continuously and it gets tired continuously.
Yeah.
So there's times that I just feel like I need to reset, and because I've been having weeks that are just going on forever. Gotcha. And so when things feel burdensome is when I feel like I'm overdoing it. And so I try to just have a break and be like.
So, you know, in this process, do you ever feel like you're ever down?
Yeah,
like you feel like your mood is down?
For sure. I always think about these words that Carl Lentz said, and it's like leaders are not allowed to have a bad day.
Okay.
And there's a truth to that in the sense that when you're leading other people in different aspects, you have to be on your top of your game no matter what.
Yeah.
So I've learned that when I want to be down, I need to be home.
Okay.
Because I don't want to bring nobody else down because I wasn't ready to have the top of my game. My mind isn't right. My spirit isn't right. My emotions aren't right.
Gotcha.
And so I might say something out of pocket, or I might do something out of pocket.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, like, there's days that I just go home. I'll just watch a movie.
Yeah.
Get a cup of tea or something and literally turn on a candle and just chill. Like.
So, but you know, in that down though, would you say that's like the what we talked about, like a micro dose of depression? You will say?
I don't know, because I always feel like if I try to use those words, I'm disrespecting somebody who goes through those things.
Gotcha.
I think. I think it's just like depletion. Like, you know, when you're depleted, when you just feel like you're empty for a little bit. You know, we all run on some kind of fuel.
Yeah.
And eventually if you're not filling yourself up, you're emptying yourself out.
Gotcha. Yeah.
And so I think for me, sometimes I feel like I'm running out because I haven't been giving myself that time. And so lately I've been thinking, yo, you need the gym, like that consistency of pushing your body to the next level, whether you have a horrible day or not at the gym, is still challenging you to be a better man in different aspects of your life. Yeah. And so that's where I'm at lately. I'm like, yo, if you're not going to be in the gym, at least hit 200 push-ups at home.
Yeah.
You got me? Because I can hit 200 push-ups in a couple of minutes. At least that. You know, get something going. Get some planks. Get some abs. Something, you know.
Yeah.
But I think a lot of us, when we get frustrated or tired or empty, we give up on the things that have been building us up instead of figuring out what is not working for this season.
Gotcha.
Like, every season is different. And we just have to have the self-awareness to say, you know what? I'm in the same season anymore. Some things are shifting. And they're shifting rapidly. I think that's what you were saying right now is true.
Yeah.
is that, you know, life hits at you and you're like, dude, I don't know how to adjust. Yeah. I'm 25 now. Part of me feels like, you know, I'm good. I'm chilling. Part of me feels like, should I be married by now? Should my finances be on like A1? Like, yeah. You know, and so you start checking yourself like, dude, I don't know. And then different things start wondering in like, dude, what am I doing? Gotcha. And so if you don't know, if you don't have a standard, which I do, mm-hmm. You start saying, yo, I'm throwing away my life.
Yeah.
And I'm not. So that's what I'm processing lately. It's like, yo, just chill. You're good.
Yeah.
Gotcha. You're not great. Because no one is perfect. No one's there yet. There is.
Yeah.
But you're good. You'll be all right. Gotcha. And I think that's where it is.
You know, and it's interesting, you know, because you said you don't want to use those kind of words because you don't want to take away from what anybody's feeling, right? But, you know, at the end, like, everybody does go through those emotions, mm-hmm. those small fluctuations, yeah. Right? Like, you know, I was talking with a friend Friday, right? And, you know, I was telling her, like, you know, it's funny because lately I've been feeling down. You get me? Like, very down for, like, the last couple months, mm-hmm. right? And it's like, is using the word depressed, I understand where you're coming from with it, but I feel like that's what it is. You get me? Mm-hmm. The thing is that I don't have nothing to like be, it's not like, you know, have a loss or something like that, right? But it's also like, you know, when you start to do your research and stuff, mm-hmm. you start to kind of follow mm-hmm. up on things like, yo, you know, food causes some type of depression. Yeah. You know,
chemical imbalances, right?
It's different things. So, mm-hmm. you know, for me, because I don't have a process of elimination for some of these things, I don't understand what it is. You get me? So in my head is going crazy because other times I'll be at work and I just feel down. I'm like, shit, bro. Like, I feel like I don't have that distractor. Mm-hmm. You get me? And it's almost like what you said, like, you know, things going so fast. It's like, it's almost like us, you know, we kind of start to adapt to like this speed, right? And once we don't have this, like, mm-hmm. this speed going, like, shit slows down, you realize, like, yo, what am I holding on to?
Like, in those quiet moments.
Yeah, yeah. It's like, what am I holding on to? Because, I mean, like, for me, like, just like you said, it's been a vibe for me to come home. And, like, I like, you know, I light up that candle. You know, that candle, not smell it. Remember I was saying I couldn't smell it? I could smell it. I guess I have to, like, take some time.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But, you know, I light up the candle and have the room dark, right? And I like to take a shower when I come in. The room is just dark. It smells good. Mm-hmm. It's a little vibe. You get me? But I'm chilling here and I'm thinking, damn, like, I don't feel like I'm doing what I'm supposed to be doing. Like, I feel like I need to be doing more.
Yeah.
You know, but there's also that little thing that's, like, it's almost like this pain, right? Mm-hmm. Like, at least from what I feel when I was talking with my friend, she was saying the same thing. It's almost like this pain that you can't quite fathom, like, where it's coming from. Yeah, like, why?
You can't pinpoint it.
Right, you know, because it's almost like, and you know, depending on how you're raised, you know, I mean, like, for me, it's almost like this, like, dose of toxic masculinity, right? It's like, come on, bro, like, tighten up. You shouldn't even be feeling like this.
You gotta be better than this.
Right, but, you know, we also know that, you know, we need to be dealing mm-hmm. with these kind of things. Yeah. So, like, it brought me to a point, remember, we were talking about, like, you know, a lot of people, when, you know, you're poor, let's say, right, it's hard for you to build up on your mental, mm-hmm. your emotional stuff because you're too busy trying to, like, mm-hmm. you know, come up with cash, right? So I kind of thought, I'm like, well, am I at a point in my life right now, right, like, at this moment, where financially I'm good to be dealing with emotional stuff? Mm-hmm. You get what I'm saying? Because if I was dealing with money stuff, I wouldn't even be thinking about my emotional mm-hmm. stuff. And I'll be thinking about what job I'm going to get next, like how I'm going to get money. You get me? So I didn't even know whether to see, because I'm trying to see all points of view. Yeah, you get me? Just trying to change my perspective on it, because is this a good thing? Is this a bad thing? Like, what's going on? Could it be like some repressed emotions maybe from a long time ago?
Maybe something's been bottling up.
Right. And I wouldn't have an answer for. You know what I'm saying?
I think one of the best things I ever heard somebody tell me is, like, if you think you're good, get a therapist.
Okay. Oh, wow. Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like,
that's interesting. That's an interesting notion.
Because I think we all have some stuff. Yeah. And you mentioned a lot of it. It's like, as Hispanic men, you know, we don't have conversations about emotion a lot.
Yeah.
About, you know, I feel down and it's okay. Like, it's kind of like what is wrong with you? You can't afford to feel down.
Right.
You can't afford to feel some type of way.
As men, like, yeah,
and,
general,
and it kind of kills a part of you that is essential.
Yeah.
You know, I think women are so special in the sense that they manage to be in tune with these emotions.
Yeah.
Sometimes they may not be able to convey it. Like, mm-hmm. women will tell you, I don't know, I just feel some type of way.
Yeah.
Right, but they are in tune with it, and if we don't have words or a verbiage to convey how we're feeling, then we can't get up past it. And that's why sometimes I don't use words like depression. I don't use words like down. I'll just say off.
Yeah.
Because I know how I normally am and I know how I'm being at the moment.
Yeah.
It's like, I'm off. I don't know what it is. I don't know if I'm sad. I don't know if I'm happy. I don't know if I'm tired. I don't know if, I don't know if I'm hangry, like, you know, it's like caffeine, like lacking or whatever it is. But I think it's essential that we're honest with these things. Like, you know, people get tired, bro. It's like life goes so fast. And I can imagine, you know, like, at least in my scale, it's like I'm busy. But even so, imagine somebody who has literally everything going on. Like, you have kids.
Yeah.
You have a job. You have bills. You have blah, blah, blah.
Right, right.
Like, even if I were to lose my job today, like, no, screw it. I'll still live with my parents. Like, they're not going to kick me out. Right, you know? Right, right. Imagine somebody who's like, yo, if I don't have income.
Yeah, like, then I'm evicted. I'm in the streets.
It's like, but even in that moment, we have to be able to prioritize what matters. Like, keep the number one things. Like, your health matters in every aspect. And if we're not careful, because life is moving so fast, we'll just empty ourselves out. And that's what suicide is so, like, prevailing in our society. Well, that's why everybody has Xans or Ambiens or whatever you want to call it, because they're just trying to
self-medication.
Like, you're just trying to find something, you know, like to get me through today. And and that's rough,
right? And you know, it's funny that you say that, because, like, you know, that feeling right there, right, it's like, okay, you know, I was telling my friend, so I was saying, you know, it's funny how, like you just said, you know, you're tired of going out, and it's like, you know, there's a new season, you change pace. You know, I remember there was a time where we used to go out all the time, right? And we said, it was like this, there's going out, going out. Right. Yeah. And, you know, like, when that comes to a slowdown, right? And, like, you think, like, okay, well, you know what? My day is going to be filled with this and that. You know, like, the thing that I enjoyed the most, and that's when we kind of came up with the I'm down and everything, right? Because that's the time when we were kind of just exploring and having this adventure.
Facts,
I was telling her, like, you know, I feel like, to my extent, I was like, I almost need, like, a reboot of, like, just doing something random. Going to Costa Rica, going to surf, like, something crazy like that.
Yeah, something you don't do normally.
Because it's almost like you get stuck in a cycle. Yeah, I mean, and it's so true. Like, when you get stuck in that cycle, like, you're in a hamster wheel, just, you know, doing the same thing, doing the same thing, not kind of getting nowhere. You feel like shit. Like,
yeah, you're not right.
Yeah, like, you need this change of pace. And it's crazy that, you know, you get these feelings when in reality, though, everybody gets these feelings, right? But when you have these feelings, you just don't really know, like, where to actually put them. Yeah. You know what I mean? It's like, they're just there. You can't convey, like, you know. So you said girls are in tune, though. But I was going to ask, like, so you think that every guy needs a girl to help him get in tune with that? Or you feel like, because, I mean.
No, I think some men have breakthroughs. Not everybody's raised the same way.
Right.
But I think some men have breakthroughs. Some men understand that, you know, being stressed, being depressed, these are real things. I just think we don't have enough education. Like, if you can't if you can't put a word to something, then you don't fully understand it. And a lot of us, that's the problem, is we haven't been given the tools of vocabulary. We don't know how to openly speak about the things we feel or we're going through until it's too late, because no one gave us the weapons of words. Words are weapons, right? And I know that has a bad connotation, but it also has a good connotation. Because words can be to kill, but it also can be to build up. If I can tell you words of affirmation in your rough seasons, then you might be able to make it through the rough season. If you can tell me, dude, no matter what you go through, I'm with you, then that builds us up. I think women have that. You know, this idea of hey, no matter what, I'm with you. This girl power, this motherhood, this sisterhood thing that men usually don't have, because unless you find people who are real good friends, everybody's competing with each other. Like, low-key, you don't admit it, but you compare yourself to the person next to you, especially the dude next to you, because it's like this whole alpha male idea of, I got to be the top dog, you know?
If you're in the alpha dog
mentality, right? Yeah, and if not, then you just feel inadequate anyways, because you feel like, oh, I'm not even going to worry about fighting that competition because I lost. And so, as men, we have to give each other that weapon to say, hey, you know, this is an open space. Talk. And something's going to be awkward because you won't know what to say. You're going to be like, I don't know. I don't know how to, I just feel some way. I just whatever. I don't know if it's depression. I don't know if it's this and this. But you got to be able to be honest and open. And those are circles or spaces that don't fully exist for men. You know, you hear rappers talk about it. You hear politicians talk about it. Like, they're just like, I'm just going through something. Can you expand? I don't know what it is. Because you don't have the words yet to convey that message.
It's such a difficult thing when you really come to think about it, because, you know, these feelings that you're saying, like, we don't have words to express them. They, like, if we kind of just, like, again, like most men do, just, okay, like, let's just put this down, let's just put this down. They always going to come back.
For sure.
I mean? Always going to come back, and eventually you have to deal with it. Otherwise, it's going to deal with you. You get what I'm saying?
It's going
to
come back.
It's really like this, it's like, it's very hard to, like, even, like, explain it, but it's so true. Like, guys really don't have that that I guess like that like the ability or the permission in society to be like, okay, go ahead and be weak. You get me? Like you can't be that guy, because then it's like you're always gonna be looked down upon. You get what I'm saying? Yeah. So
it's like you missed your role or whatever. Yeah. And we expect women to do this. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But I think that everybody should be expected to do this.
Yeah.
If we have healthy people in every aspect, then we'll have good people.
Yeah.
If you're hurting in one aspect, then you're hurting. Like, think about it. You got 3 good tires in a car. You have 1 flat. It's still not moving.
Yeah. It's gonna move real rough.
Yeah. It's like, you know, you're still gonna hear.
Yeah.
And eventually, it goes to a point that you mess with the rim. You're not moving at all. If we have 3 facets in which we're succeeding, and we're still not taking care of that last one.
Yeah.
We're gonna get to a point that we can't get farther.
Yeah.
And I think that is what we need to be mindful of. It's like, it's okay to not be okay. Yeah. It's okay to just figure it out.
Yeah.
We're whatever.
You know, like I said before, you know, the thing that I really like about this is that, you know, like right now, we don't have an answer.
Yeah.
Right? But we acknowledge that we're dealing with something, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that later down the line, we probably would have an answer.
Yeah.
You get me?
Yeah.
Or like a way to help somebody in this position. Maybe, but like, you know, in a year from now, or maybe a little bit longer, right? But, you know, it's good to have this, again, like, documented. You know, like, people, they do vlogs or whatever. Yeah. You know, in our case, like, it's good to have this documented because you revisit these things later on.
Yeah, and then you realize shift.
That you can see the change. You get me? So, dope. Let's kind of change the pace tempo. Here. Yeah, a little bit. Because, you know, I asked some questions this week, right? And let me get this down. I asked a couple because okay, so the first one I asked, so I was in this debate, right, basically with I won't call it debate, but
conversation,
like a disagreement. So it's called a disagreement with a co-worker of mine, right? And she was saying that, you know, she prefers a dad bod over a fit bod, right? And I know, like, you know, I put the polls, you put dad bod, right? You voted for dad bod.
Always. Always.
My thing was this. And I've said this before, right? I think that it's always going to depend on where the girl's at.
Yeah,
if the girl is fit,
yeah,
she wants a guy to be fit. If she is not fit, she has a mom bod, then she wants a guy to have a dad bod, right? It's like holding up a mirror in a way. You get me?
Yeah, I mean, she doesn't want to have like a super fit guy. She's not fit, and then she feels insecure. Like, dang, what if he finds somebody who's fit?
Exactly.
But if then,
maybe not find somebody, but you feel like you're not at that level.
Yeah, for sure.
Right. So when the poll came back, it wasn't like a whole bunch of people. Let me actually see how many people voted in total. So it was 8 people went for fit bod, 6 people went for dad bod, right? So what's that? That's a total of like what, 14 people? So out of 14 people, it's pretty close, right? What's the percentage there? It's what's that? That's like 57-43%, right? 57%, 43%. Yeah. Not that big of a difference, right? But you know, again, if you study the people who voted, right?
Dad bods voted dad bods.
Right. So it kind of goes. Well, I mean, I don't know why you voted dad bod, though. You don't have a dad bod.
I have a dad bod.
No, you don't have a dad bod.
I have a sexy dad bod, though.
No. You don't have a dad bod.
I have a stud dad.
You know,
dad
a dad bod is like being skinny fat.
Yeah, like you got the belly, but you kind of like slim down.
It's like being skinny, but you still have like a high body fat percentage, right? That's like essentially it. You know, but I'm going to be honest with you. What is a fit bod? I don't even know.
That's a question I was going to ask you. Yeah. Like, how do you quantify that?
Right. Like, I don't even know what that is. Because there's people I see.
I would argue I don't have a fit bod.
Okay.
But somebody would probably say you have a fit bod.
Right. Like, it's true. Like, I think that, you know, that kind of comes individualized. But, like, generally speaking, like, for example, in the gym, right? Like, there's a lot of people in the gym that I would say they're swole. But it's fit, like, being like slim down with muscle, or is it being like just muscle in general? Like, I don't even know.
I don't know what the level of fitness is.
Right. I wouldn't even know.
Is it just like fit body compared to me? Like, is that what everybody voted? Like, I came on the lap, so, you know, fit body.
So here's the thing. So being average, I guess, will consider you not really being a gym goer, right? Mm-hmm. Maybe like you run or something like that. You get me? But you don't really have muscle or nothing like that, right? I guess that would be like an average body type. And obviously, you know, obesity and being fat, like, two different things. And then I don't know what level of, like, fit is fit. Mm-hmm. You get what I'm saying? Like, I feel like, what would you consider to be fit bod? Like, if you had to think, what would you consider to be fit body? Because for me, it'll be like, okay, someone who's built up a frame, right, in their body, like a frame, meaning that you can see outlines, you can start seeing like little things kind of come into play and have some muscle to them. You get me? Like they're doing some lifts, they're doing some things. And for girls, it'll be like, for me, it'll be like the same thing. So I guess it'll come down to like, yo, if you at least have a frame of like that shoulder to like waist ratio for men, you get me? I'm not, it doesn't have to be like some like exaggerated, like, yo, you're super muscular, but some type of frame. And then for women would be the same thing to me. Like, you know, like that hip to waist ratio type of frame. Yeah, you know what I mean? Yeah, yeah. I guess I would constitute that as like, oh, you look fit. You have to be a gym goer to be fit, though. I wouldn't just because you look like that naturally, I wouldn't call you fit. You have to be like a gym goer.
This is like that runner's body, which doesn't really look fit. Yeah, like, fit it looks skinny.
Yeah, yeah.
But they're like super cut.
Right. Yeah, well, but you know, you mean like the marathon people who are like super.
Because they're like super cut. Like there's like.
I wouldn't consider that a fit body.
No?
I mean, I'm sure their fitness, like their cardiovascular is up there, right? Like they're healthy.
Yeah.
But I don't think health and fitness is the same thing right now. You get me?
So, like, but
because you can be healthy and run 25
miles, bro, you're fit.
I mean, yes, to the level of fitness, like a test, like a fitness test, sure. But you fitness mean fit like bod,
you mean like fit to you is like you can handle the lifts.
Look, I'll give you an example. Remember, like back in PE, right? They did all the fitness. So they grab calipers, they test your body fat. They see how long you can run a mile for. How many push-ups and sit-ups you could do, right? Like, there's people that don't really have much muscle that can complete that. I mean, I would complete that back in the day.
Yeah, I would have no problem, yeah.
Exactly, you know? If that level, okay, cool. But I think when we're talking about fit bods, we're talking about, like, a certain level of body fat and muscle. You get what I'm saying? Like, I think that's what could... Like, how good do you look with your shirt off, in other words? You know what I mean? Like, I think fit bod almost consists of, like, do you have, like, somewhat of a beach body?
Yeah,
in a
okay,
way, you
know what I mean?
Like, can you wear... Can girls wear a bathing suit and look good? Like,
can a guy can take off his trunks? Shirt?
Yeah, and, you know what I'm saying? So,
and be cut up.
I don't know. Well, look, most girls pick... The point here, most girls pick fit bod. I think that most girls would pick fit bod anyways. Yeah, you know what I mean? Like,
sure.
Yo... In Hollywood, when we see Thor take his shirt off, all the girls, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, nobody wanted Thor with his dad bod.
Which, by the way, let me tell you something. Thor being fat, it was one of the greatest things ever. You know, you see a guy who's really grieving, who's depressed, you know what I'm saying? But he's out here.
He's drinking
saying?
Beer with like cereal or something. Yeah.
But I'm saying, like, you know, in Hollywood or in anything that, you know, we see, like, the dad bod is not, like, a sexy thing. Like, it's not something that we've seen. It's like, oh, like, you know what I'm saying?
Like, nah, it's like you kind of just, like, that neighbor, you know? Like,
yeah. But the minute you have a six-pack, though, it's like, yo, okay, like, you know, you've entered this realm of, like, okay, like, you can be. Because I don't think People's magazines ever put, like, the sexiest man, you know, that they do a sexiest man thing. I don't think that guy's not been fit.
He has to be sexy. Is synonymous with physical.
Yes.
No, yes, it's perfection.
Like, I want to say perfection, but physical. Like you have to be somewhat physically.
Yeah, like
at
your prime whatever.
And you know, and even the same thing, like the next question I had asked is like, you know, a question we've been asked is like, yo, do people even date anymore, right? Like, what do people do? And, you know, people put stuff like tacos, museums. A girl put museums, coffee shop, and I don't know what else. And I feel like the people who answer that, I don't know, but I was asking more on the case of first dates. Those seem like, I guess you could do that for a first date. Like, I don't see nothing wrong with doing that as a first date. I don't know if people do that for first dates.
I don't know, man. Like, I feel like unless you know about, like, the museum you're going to.
Right.
Like, if you know, if you're going to history, you better know about history.
Right.
If you're going to a museum of natural science, you better know about science.
Miami does that?
That's my point. My point is, like, Miami doesn't have that culture. Why do you have Pezier and you have, like, Vizcaya, Science Museum? But yeah, most people here, like at least our age, I wouldn't think are there.
Yes, I wouldn't think so either.
I think they just meet at the club, to be honest with you. I think they're two big C's is where people meet.
Okay.
The clubs and the church. Like, I don't know that all church people people.
Yeah,
and all club people date club people.
Yeah.
Like,
you know,
I think those are the two big C's.
You might be right.
Yeah, two big C's.
I mean, we've seen in certain churches, right? Yeah. Like, there's like very pretty girls and very attractive guys. Yeah, I guess you could say,
so,
right?
Like, I think it's just like the two spaces where people usually.
It's the same thing with the clubs. Synonymous with the club. You might be right.
And neither of them are really like, really, really constitute dates.
Yeah.
Because in church, you're not allowed to date technically.
Yeah.
And, you know, like, not like very strict, right?
Yeah.
So, like, you gotta take somebody with you, blah, blah, blah. So it's not really dating. It's like group dating.
True.
At the club, you technically group date too. Because you and your homie, she's with your girl.
So it's like,
You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, group dating is, yeah, what we are at.
Well, but look at it like this, though. This is why I think, like, you know, social media has changed the scope, right? So I'm watching Friday, right? Mm-hmm. And, you know, Smokey's talking to a girl by the phone, right? So this is how old this stuff is. Look at how old school this is, right? So back in the day, right, if you're, so the way this goes down is that his friend's trying to hook him up with a girl, right? So she's like, oh, here's her number, you know, give her a call. I'm sure that, you know, they talked about it before. She said, cool, give her my number, right? So this is how old stuff is. Back in the day, you had to call a girl through a landline. So he's calling her through a landline. He's like, hey, you know, what's up? Describe yourself, right? So this is where shit gets, like, very dangerous, right? This is where we see, like, the Tinder profiles. Yeah, because when she pulls up. Yeah, yeah. So she's like, you know, hey, I'm 5'2", I'm light skin, I got long hair, I'm thick. They tell me I look like Janet Jackson. You know, he's pumped up. He's like, Janet Jackson? Yeah. You know, he's pumped up. He's happy. He sets up a date, right? He's like, yo, I'm going to pull up like around 9. He's like, all right, cool. You know, whatever. That date gets set up. Like, that's like, almost like a date.
She pulled up.
So she pulls up. She gets out the car. He looks like it's not it. You know what I mean? Yeah, exactly. It's like, ooh. Like, he's like, god damn. Like, you know, it's not it. I'm like, holy shit. You know, now... That's why now it's so easy to for you to like just I'm not feeling this person because now we have Instagram, we have Tinder profiles, you have all these things, right? Like that verify the look of the person. You know what I mean? Like, realistically, if somebody looks at your Instagram, and if you don't have an Instagram nowadays, or you don't have like any type of social media, you look weird. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So unless they meet you in person, you know what I mean, and like they get to know you, you're basically not gonna get, like, the only people you're talking to are people from, like, your area. You know what I mean? Otherwise, you're not really expanding into any other, because, look, I've had communications with people from different countries, different states, and stuff like that because of social media. You know what I mean? Like, we're able to communicate, like, at work, I'm able to talk to people from Costa Rica, and they're in a whole different continent.
Yeah, for sure.
You know what I mean? Because of what we have, the technology that we have today. So now it's a little different because now it's like, oh, I know what you look like. You get me? So I get the pick of the litter in the sense of I'm going to message you or not.
There's also constant communication. So before you get to that first date, most likely you've already filtered.
Oh, yeah.
You get what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
So because, like, you can skip through all that boring nonsense of, like, what's your favorite color, blah, blah, blah.
Right.
Because you've already DM'd or texted this.
Exactly.
You get me? And so because of that, you've determined... and I want to give him, or I'm a ghost him, or I'm a ghost her.
Right. Like, but by that time, you kind of make the decision. Yeah. You know what? You make me laugh enough. I'm gonna say yes to you, and then you know, I mean, girls, right? From a girl's point of view, I would imagine it's like, sure, let's meet up, and you know, at that point, whoa, that's thunder.
So
at that point, you're no longer trying to, like, you know, do I like this person or not? You kind of should gauge.
Yeah, yeah.
At this point, now your decision is, can I stand you in person? You know, do I like your vibe in person?
Are you the same kind of flow that was like when we were talking texting?
Because, you know, texting is very different too. You know, like, it's easier to be funny and witty through text messages than it is in person. You know?
Because
in person,
have confidence.
You have to be like this. You know, in text message, somebody texts you and you can think about that writing back like for 10, 20, 30 minutes. You get me? And then you respond back.
Yeah,
you know,
there's people who are great writers but are bad speaking. When they communicate, it's like, dude, that's not what you were saying.
So
also like that. No, it's courage, you know, the digital courage.
There we go. I haven't even heard that word in a while, but yes, that's basically what it is now. It's digital courage. It's like, you're not afraid to shoot your shot digitally because it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
It's like, okay, if you say no,
like,
who cares?
In front of that person.
Oh, yeah. Then that's when you get like the, you know, like, I don't, you know, it's so funny. So this is like a text. You know, I'm out last night. I go to a place I haven't been to in a long time, right? So, you know, we're chilling. And this very, very pretty girl comes right by us, right? So, you know, we're chilling out. It's very, like, private. You know what I'm saying? It's, like, nobody there. We're just hanging out. I'm with one friend, right? This very pretty girl comes around. And the whole, like, everybody in the place is looking at this girl, like, heavy, right? So, but the girl's by herself. You know, when you're in a social place and you're by yourself, like one of the weirdest things. Like, for you as
awful.
A person, especially
it's
you as
awful.
A pretty girl,
you
feel
awful,
so
you feel
bad.
Like everybody's looking at
exactly.
you.
Exactly. So, you know, she's kind of hovering around us. But, you know, like, I guess, you know, call it whatever you want. But, you know, I kind of have this habit where, like, if somebody's paying attention to you, like, heavy, I usually don't try to pay attention to you at all. You know what I mean? Like, it's almost like you're not getting that attention from me.
Because you already got the litter. You
exactly.
don't want to be that
it's like,
guy,
you know
too.
What? I'm not going to be that motherfucker paying attention to you. You get me? Like, you don't got me. You get me? So, you know, she's kind of hovering around us, and she ends up sitting right next to us, which is, like, basically right next to my friend, right? And so, like, you know, I tell him, I'm like, whatever you do, don't look at this girl and give her attention, right?
Yeah.
So what ends up happening is that she ends up reaching out to him, like, hey, can you take a picture of me, right? And mind you, she's by herself or whatever. So I'm like, okay. When he comes back, I'm like, okay, look, hold up, right? In a little bit, you're going to start talking to her, right? Uh-huh. I'm going to set it up for you. So, you know, we're talking, and she kind of asked for another picture again. I'm like, yo, I told him, I want you to get something through your head right now, all right? You're not hooking up with this girl tonight. You're not going to get this girl's number. Nothing is going to happen between you and this girl. However, I would so like for you. No, and, but I'm going to tell you why, though. I tell you know, I think people's mistakes is that. I mean, they go into talking to a girl, trying to hook up. So they, like, guys don't realize this, but they self-sabotage themselves so bad. Because they're, what they're trying to do, right, is hook up with this girl. But they're trying to do it their way. You get me? Like, they're trying to, like, be this bravado thing, right? Like, I'm going to buy you a drink, and I'm going to, like, you know, like, do these things and show all these tricks, and you're going to come home with me, right? Mm-hmm. Which I understand that there's girls out there that are like that, but that doesn't work for the most part. You get me? But the reason I'm telling that is that, yo, it's just to get the experience of having conversation with strangers mm-hmm. that gets you out of your element. You get what I'm saying? So I'm telling him, yo, have regular conversation, right? So, you know, I set it up to, like, you know, the same thing. I'm like, hey, you know, I was talking to my friend who's, you know, bartender, and she lines up 3 shots, right? So like, yo, you know, bam, let's get it popping like that, right? So you take the shots, you know, kind of like, yo, you know, kind of do your thing. But the whole thing was for him to just talk. You know what I mean? Just have that conversation, and it doesn't even matter, like, what happens. You know what I mean? Just have the conversation. Who knows? You might see this girl another day, and, like, she remembers. Yeah. You know what I mean? And, you know, I'm like, okay, you know, I'm going to leave first, okay? And then you leave after me, then whatever. And then he said, like, you know, like, they're talking. He had a hookah and stuff like that. And I tell him, like, yo, offer it to her, whatever. You know, they kind of started doing their thing. And, yo, like, by the time we left, he's like, oh, you know, she gave me a kiss on the cheek, and we said our goodbyes. And that's it. I was like, yo, that's a clean cut, like, great interaction, mm-hmm. in my opinion. You get me? You talk to a girl who's by herself. She feels awkward. Like, trust me, she definitely felt awkward. She's over here taking pictures by herself. Like, come on. Nobody wants to do that. You know what I'm saying? When you're in a very sociable place. Yeah. You get me? So it's like, you know, you took somebody who's, like, in a very, like, awkward position. Because trust me, I know girls, especially when, you know, pretty girls, they say this all the time, like, they feel weird when they're in a place and they have a bunch of guys just looking at her. You get me? So, you know, you take somebody who's in a very uncomfortable position, and you make them feel comfortable. You just have a clean interaction, mm-hmm. without bad intentions, and you keep it moving. That way you learn how to speak to a woman. Yeah. You get me? And, you know, that girl doesn't feel weird. It's like, okay, we had a shot. You know, I make sure the bartender brought it, and she gave it to her. So, you know, it's not like, oh, did you poison it? And the girl's smart, because she got the drink, and she did one of these. Now, I don't know if she did one of these to look at the color or to make sure that there's nothing in it, but girls, do that shit. You get me? Because there's a lot of Bill Cosby's out here in these streets. Yeah, you get me? So, culture. So you don't know. But you know, it was a good, clean interaction. You get me? Like, between guy and girl. And that's something that you don't see too often. You get me? Nowadays, it's like, yo, you go to the club and you try to do too much bravado shit. You get me? Like, dude, I saw a guy weighing 40 pounds. Like, when I say 40 pounds, I'm like, this guy was super skinny. Wearing, like, two of the biggest Cuban link bracelets I've ever seen in my life. And those things look crazy on him. Like, his wrist is like, yeah, I have little wrists. His wrist is like half of my wrist. And he's wearing two big old, I'm like, yo, like hanging, Gucci, like Gucci down. I'm like, yo, when I tell you in Miami, you're either t-shirts and shorts or you're Gucci down, that's facts. Like, those are the two kind of people that you're going to see the most here. You get me?
Yeah, but I mean, insane. Some people really do be thinking that works, bro. Yeah. And it might work, you know, some girls are shallow. It does. Some girls are shallow.
It works.
Yeah, but like, sure. It's always about intentionality. Like,
yeah.
What do you want to get out of, like, that, you know, interaction?
Right,
if
right.
If you really want to find, you know, someone special,
yeah,
then, you know, you got to take an approach where it's like conversation and honesty and authenticity. If not, you know, flex.
But the thing is this, though, like, okay, the whole hookup thing, right? This whole hookup thing, I think is it gets too blown out of proportion. I think first off, shit is too overrated, right? Mm-hmm. I think that, you know, when you're in high school, and, like, even I guess guys now, like, I've been saying this, I'm like, are we still giving people props for, like, sleeping with a bunch of girls? Like, are we still on that type of time still? Like, we're still doing that? Like, I feel like you get to a point where, like, okay, you have your experiences, and, like, you know, that becomes just, like, I feel like sex is overrated. You know what I mean? Like, it's way too overrated. Like, people make it like
this. We idolize it.
Yeah. Like, it's like, yo, like, I understand if you're in high school and you're like, oh, man, you got laid. Cool, bro. You got laid for prom. Like, all right. But after you've done enough, like, when does that stop? Like,
yeah,
like,
when is enough?
Yeah. So I guess that comes with, like, with a mature thing. You get me? Like, this whole, like, hooking up, you know what I'm saying? But again, I don't know. Who am I to talk? I'm just a kid from Alapad. I don't know.
I think that that's where you come to that realization where usually dudes go, nah, man, I've had that. I need something real now.
Right.
But, you know, usually if you've had luck with women, you know how to talk to women. Like, you know how to really sugarcoat women.
Though. That's the thing. I don't. Still not talk to girls. No, seriously, man. I find it so funny because even my own mom thinks that, you know, like, you know, say I'll leave the house. I'll leave the house like around 11, right? It's really just to meet up with your brother or it's just to chill. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, it is not nothing crazy. You get me? Like, I'll meet up with Eddie. Me and Eddie are just talking, like, outside, like, by the grand or something like that. You know, like, some chilling stuff. You get me? Like, it's never, like, nothing, like, crazy. Yeah. My mom be thinking that I'm, like, out here in these streets.
Like wallet.
Yeah, like she thinks like, oh, he's leaving this lake because he's going out. I'm like, yo, my guy, I'm not, you know what I'm saying? I'm really not out here in these streets. And it makes me laugh. It's so, but you know what? I guess like, I at this point, I'm tired. Like, I'm literally just like exhausted at this point. Because it's like, you know, you try to do the right thing.
And they still think you're doing the wrong thing.
Listen, I realized that for me, it doesn't matter. Like, I don't know what it is. But at this point, I don't care. Like,
you do the right thing, you do the wrong thing, it's the same thing.
It doesn't matter. Like, it literally just doesn't matter. Like, no matter what, since I was probably, like, in middle school, this thing has never left me where it's like, oh, you out here in these streets. Nigga, I'm out here in church. I was out here in church for years. You know what I'm saying? And I still got this whole, nah, you got girls, you know, whatever. And even now, I'm like, you know, it's just something that you won't escape. I guess it's like a look or whatever, but... You know, it's cool. At this point, it's cool.
Yeah, I think it is.
I give up, man.
It's a certain looks, bro.
Yeah. At this point, it's like, you know what? It's cool. But to your extent, I don't know how to talk to girls in the sense of, like, this charming, witty guy. You get me? Like, I just have conversations. Like, I will talk to you, like, just to talk to you. But it's hard for me to talk to you and try to put down with you. That's the hardest thing to ever do. That's what's so exhausting about that.
I think that that's the issue. The issue is dudes who try to put down. Like, the most successful way of putting down is not trying to put down.
Right. It's which is just, almost counterintuitive. Yeah, though, it's
just
people.
Being, like, you know, just conversating. Like, just, you know, like, being yourself. I know that sounds like cliche.
Yeah,
whatever.
Yeah.
Being yourself, being open. And just, like, if you are witty and funny, be witty and funny. But if not, don't try to be witty and funny.
Right. I think there's this thing, though, that, like, it's almost like we all have to be the same in order to get girls.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? Like,
dumb.
Like, we all have to, right, which is... It is, but at the same time, it's not, though. You know what I mean? Because if you see, like, an approach. So, for example, if you're seeing that the guy with the nice car and the nice clothes is constantly getting the pretty girls.
Then you automatically associate
it
with.
It's just natural, like, okay, like, you know, this is what I have to do to get these kind of girls. You know what I mean? Because it's not working because I'm wearing Abercrombie Fitch. It's just not working out. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's not.
Sure.
It's not it. So, I think it's just natural.
But it was on sale.
Well, you see, but some girls will see that as, like, yo, he's a good money saver.
Yeah.
Other girls will see that as he's a broke boy.
But it's also about context, man. Like, if you find her at the club, she's not thinking about money saving.
Man, I don't know. You know, you don't know that. I think girls at the club are money savers, though.
No, they're money savers. They're not thinking about you saving your money because they're depending on you wasting your money.
But actually, you know, let's get to that. So let me ask you this. So you meet a girl at the club, right? You know, girls at clubs don't waste no money. I think if you're a girl,
I think if you guys, like, should only waste money when she's only with her friends.
No.
Well, I don't mean like, I mean in every setting. Like, if there's a dude around, you can usually get something free.
Well, okay. You mean in the club, though. You mean, I'm talking about specifically in the club.
Oh,
like,
okay.
If a girl's in the club, I don't think you should pay for anything ever.
Oh, no.
Like, you should have the game dialed down
to a guy buys you a drink.
Exactly. Yeah. Like, you should have that dialed down. But there's the thing, though. If you're letting guys, though, buy you drinks at the club, you're that guy's girlfriend for that day. Like, yes, I think we need to start getting this. I think that the game's getting too messed up, right? I'm gonna tell you why. So, girls have this thing where, like, okay, you know, I'm gonna let the guy buy me drinks. I don't care. You know, okay, cool. You know what I'm saying? But you're letting somebody invest in you the entire night for you to not do nothing. And I'm not talking about sex. This has nothing to do with sex.
Just hang.
It has nothing to do with going back home with it. It has nothing to do, but we gotta get something out of this
just
transaction. Give me your number. You know what I'm saying? Like, give me some hope. Give me some hope. Now, I think that's completely... Like, it defeats all laws, for one. You get me? It's completely immoral and unethical to do that.
Wow. Okay.
Yes. Because, listen. If we're at a place, right? Give me a fake number, at least. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm going to tell you what. Fake numbers don't work nowadays. But, you got to give me something, bro. Because you cannot... I can't be buying you and your girl's drinks all night and I don't get nothing from you. Like, what? Why? Why would we do this? You know that I like you, right? So you gotta be my girlfriend. You gotta be my girlfriend. You cannot let me buy you. Well, first of all, look, I'm not that guy. You get me?
First of all,
I don't have that kind of big account to do that.
I always told you, if a guy wants to be a duck, let him quack. Like, you know?
No, man. Well, tell me, okay. That is the easiest way to get a girl's attention in the club.
It is, but
the only way actually to get a girl's attention in the club. You're not getting her to look. You know, it's too hard out here in the streets. You know what I mean?
No, obviously, in a place that's
too much competition.
A place that's filled with too many people.
Yeah, like too many guys, man.
Yeah, that's true. But if a guy wants to be a duck, let him quack. You don't owe a guy nothing because
Let him quack. But what do you do with ducks? You feed them some bread, right? You go to the park. Right, you crush out the old bread that you have and you feed it to them, right?
Exactly. So
okay, you gave him a wig, feed him some bread.
You gave him your name and you kept moving.
No, that's not feeding him bread.
Yeah.
No, your name is the bag. You know what I'm saying? The bread has to be some numbers in there. Nah, it has to be some we feed ducks at the park, right? We feed ducks at the park. So if a duck wanna quack, feed him some bread. There's nothing wrong with that. Nah. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, there's not. There has to be something. But there shouldn't be nothing expected.
What do you mean?
There should be.
Yo, absolutely.
Imagine if a guy went up to a girl and be like, dude, I bought you drinks. You owe me your number.
No. That's disrespectful. You got to play it smoother than that. You know, if you do it like that, you don't deserve to get the number. You get me? Because that means you didn't have enough common sense, you get me, to try to be smooth enough to get this number. You know, you gotta have some swag to you. You get what I'm saying? Like, you got to at least appeal. You know what I'm saying? But if you're a girl, you know, you're not interested in this guy at all. You know what I mean? Don't have this guy. Look, if this guy comes up to you and decides, hey, I'm gonna buy you and your friends all a drink, cool. But don't let this guy spend all night buying you drinks and then you know you're not gonna give him no play. That's unethical. That's unethical behavior. That's unacceptable. So you don't agree?
I think she shouldn't do that either, but if she gets it.
I mean, okay, again, we can see two sides of the argument here. Sure, cool for the girl, right? Oh, I played this guy, blah, blah, blah. But come on, man. I mean, you get with a guy and he cheats on you, you want to get mad.
No, but you know why I don't see it that way? Because I guess I'm not that guy. I'm not the guy that would feel compelled to buy a girl anything for her attraction or attention. So that's why I see it like, yo, if he wants to do it, go ahead and do it.
Yeah, but I'm like, saying that's how you make... Look, this is the thing. If you're an attractive guy, right? And that's an attractive girl and you both have an attraction to each other. Like you know, you guys made that eye contact. Okay. Bam, you click, right? And you go, and he buys you that drink, you're going to give him some play. And not play as in, like, I'm going to go sleep with him. I'm talking about, like, you give me a number. Yeah. You guys will probably talk. Who knows, right? Something will happen. You get me? But now, if you're not attracted to this guy, he just buys you a drink. Okay, fine. He bought you the drink. Take it. You know what I'm saying? Make sure it has no pills in it. Nothing. But don't let this guy buy you drinks all night. Because that's unethical, man. That's fucked.
Some people are sad, okay, bro.
So now when you have a guy, right, that you think you're seeing, but he's fucking a whole bunch of other girls, you want to get mad. And you want to be like, oh, you want to go on Twitter talking about this motherfucker is fucked up. Think about that.
Can you explain how that equates to one thing to the other?
Of course, because, okay, you come through, right, and you offer this dude whatever the fuck you offered him for you guys to end up hooking up together, right? Now, you started catching feelings, right? And now you feel like he owes you something loyalty in return. I caught feelings, so now you have to be loyal to me. But he didn't catch feelings. You get me? Like, that didn't happen. So, why should we be in this scenario? Because it's the same thing vice versa. The guy comes in, right? He's buying you drinks or whatever. He's trying to catch feelings for you, and you're saying the same thing. So, we got to keep the same energies here. You get me? If you're the kind of girl who's letting a dude buy you drinks all the time, right? Knowing that you're not going to give him no play, then you can't be mad if the dude that you have no quote-unquote committed relationship with or whatever, you start catching feelings. You have no reason to get mad at that guy either. You have to look at it like that. You don't agree?
I don't know if it's the same level.
It's
bro.
The same thing, though.
But it's not the same level. The principle...
Why is it not the same level?
The principle may be the same, but the level... Because, like, you can equate someone giving you stuff to giving somebody your body. I guess.
Why not?
And I'm telling you, look.
It's all material. Some people see things from a different point of view.
You're right. I understand that point of view, and I can relate to that point of view. Okay. But that doesn't mean I equate it the same. So, for example, look. Can I excuse the girl for getting pissed off for something that wasn't completely explained between the two? No. That's on her.
Okay. Right.
The same way that it's on this guy who's buying drinks for a girl expecting something that wasn't completely communicated.
Right.
So I don't blame the player. I blame the game.
No. You see, but that's where I feel like the problem arises, though. We can't We have to hold people accountable for their actions. You get me? We cannot charge everything to the game, okay? We cannot everything do that. Everything is a game. No, if the game is broken. If we charge everything to the game, the game will be
broken.
In debt.
Okay? The game is broken. It isn't debt.
The game will be grease. You know what I'm saying? The game will not be good.
The game is broken, bro.
No, man. Look, if you're a girl and you let these guys buy you drinks and knowing you're not going to give them no play, you're the worst of this community. You're the worst of this community.
You heard it here first.
Yes, you are not. You are not a good community builder. You're not a good ego builder. Build some egos out here. You know what I'm saying? Women's jobs out here is to build men up. Understand that men need women. You get me? Men are usually nothing until a girl comes along and does builds it right, them up. Yeah. Yes, you know, you got to build these men up. These guys out here thinking that they could just buy you drinks and get cutty. No, you get me? That's wrong. But build up some ego. Make them feel like, okay, you know, this worked with this girl. It might work next time. You get me? Like, you have to reward sometimes bad disciplines because you do. You have to reward it sometimes.
You're going
to
teach a dog new tricks.
Yes, you have to reward. Sometimes you have to reward bad discipline because it teaches lessons.
Nah.
Of course. Mm-mm. Of course. Because you can, look, when's the last time you didn't give a duck some bread?
I'm never giving ducks bread.
Okay, you're not in that white people place yet. Trust me, when you get a home where you have like a lake in the back and you have quack quacks.
I walk with my trust wife. You walk with your
son. You walk with your son, you holding his hand, he's gonna wanna feed the ducks. And you guess what you're gonna do? You're gonna have some opa molde, you get me? The little sandwich bread.
The ugly one that nobody wants, the friend in the back.
Exactly. Those, you know, I'd be eating those two ones anyways.
Really?
Yeah, I'd be eating those. The butts or whatever, I guess that's what it's called. I'd be eating them things.
There's a weird name for it, but I just don't know where it is.
I don't know. I'd be eating them sometimes. Listen, bro, it's survival's mentality out here in these streets, all right? You gotta get what you get, you know? You're not used to that life. You're a very privileged young man.
First of all, there's like,
that's privilege.
No,
when you can afford to throw away the two.
I didn't throw them away. I'm just not the one eating them. Somebody else is eating them.
Yeah, okay.
Yo, you know how many people are in my house?
Yeah, if you have that mentality, somebody else in your house has that mentality too.
Yeah, but not everybody in my house.
How do you know?
Because they're always gone. Somebody eventually eats them.
Somebody probably threw it away. That's what happened. Or tell you what, somebody fed the ducks with it.
Oh, the dogs.
Somebody fed the
ducks.
In our
case, it's the dogs.
Okay, dogs, ducks. The same thing, Chris. It's the same thing. I'm telling you, man. Listen, bro. If you are...
Now, it's a difference between a dog and a dog.
I'm giving a good listen. If me. It's let's say me.
The dog knows who to go to get food. The dog goes to whoever throws him a crumb.
Oh, that's deep. That's deep. Okay,
like a,
Chris.
Sound like a fortune cookie.
Okay, Chris. That was deep. Okay. Now, I think that if I were to go to the club and I'm buying a girl drinks all night, right, thinking, oh, I'm finna get some play, I deserve not to get that number. I don't deserve to get that number. I deserve to get nothing. I deserve to go bankrupt that night. You get me?
Because you're a duck.
No, because I know better.
But if, like, somebody with no ego, you see what you're saying?
Yes. Girls, build up some egos. There's nothing wrong with that.
You're saying that she should find like the most pitiful guy.
Yeah, look, if a good-looking guy, right, is buying you drinks all night, fuck that guy. That guy has enough ego. Fuck him. I'm talking about the guy who's like nerdy-ish, you know what I'm saying?
This is the first time going out.
Yeah, build some ego, man. There's nothing wrong with that. Reward some bad behavior because some of these guys need it. Some of these guys need it. You get me? I think that we do too much harm than good sometimes. You get me? And girls, if you have the gift of being a beautiful young lady and you have the gift of actually knowing how to dress well, you know what I'm saying? And you have a nice body, there's going to be guys after you, you know? And the good-looking guys, fuck those guys. Those guys have enough ego, enough arrogance. But those nerdy guys, build some fucking ego. You get me? But make them feel like, you know what? That one time I was out there in Miami, I got that girl. You know, I got that girl's number. You know what I'm saying? Like,
I got her IG.
Yeah, build some confidence. You know what I'm saying? Because we lack too much of that. You know what I mean? Look, when you lack confidence, you get me? That's where you get the man beaters. The guys that are beating girls because they lack confidence, man. You get me? It's one of two things. You lacking confidence... You know, let's not get to that second part. Let's not be too vulgar. But, you know, it's most of the time, you just lack confidence. Because think about it. What gets you to the point of you ever hitting a girl? Because you fed up. Because you can't control or whatever, right? And I understand, trust me, man. Some girls, they deserve to get punched in the face from time to time. Not by guys, though. You know what I'm saying? I think every guy should have that sister that or that homegirl. Not you pay that. You just call them. Yo, you know what? Come over here and whoop this girl for me. You know what I'm saying? Because... Some girls deserve it. I'm going to be honest. I think some girls, that just has to get punched by a guy because it's too much. You know what I mean? It's way too much. It depends. It depends on the scenario. I seen some girls that are, bro, they bought that
life. I seen some girls eat punches. That one with the girl.
That girl deserves a round 2 rematch.
First of all, at that point is when I decided I'm going to kill her.
Yeah. No, not kill her. No, beat her ass.
I'm going down, homie.
But that's what I'm saying.
I'm going down.
That guy deserves a round 2 fight, exhibition fight, to knockout. Like, only knockout wins. Because what she did was, you're play fighting.
She sent me
but
up.
But you
she,
decide that's exactly.
That's a setup.
Exactly.
Because the way she
knew
punched,
about, she knew how to do it.
The way she punched was not like a, ooh, I'm sorry.
No. She that was duck, a duck and boom. With a left.
Connect.
Let me tell you something. If I get knocked out with a left hand and you're a right hand, we're fighting to death.
Yo, that's disrespectful.
If you're a righty and you knock me out with your left, we are fighting to the death.
First of all, like, it's hard for a dude to knock you out with his left. My this girl goodness. Rocked him. And she landed it right on the chin.
Yes. Hip and that thing and the stance. If you see her stance.
No, she engaged, bro. Full on.
Right foot in front of her. Left foot tilted back. Hip came through. Boom.
No, she drove. She drove.
Yeah, she drove. Boom. Yeah. Buddy was knocked out. I'm talking about when I tell you he went down, you didn't see him get right back up. Nah. He stayed there for a little bit. I was like, oh, I don't know this guy. And they stopped the video. Those are great friends, by the way.
Because if you see him take longer than 5 seconds, yo.
Great friends. Great friends will give you just enough humiliation. You know what I'm saying? Just enough. Like not enough like for it to like kill you,
but enough just to enough make you to feel, make you cry. Yeah,
make
you cry a little bit.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Those great friends, by the way. You cut the video at the perfect time. We saw like the defeat, the demise. We saw like the girl champion. Like she pretended like, oh my God, it was an action. She's like, like, we know that shit was bullshit.
She knew.
We knew it was bullshit. But those are great friends. You get me? I would say if they kept recording and you just see that,
like if you see him on the floor, bro, just laid out cold,
that would have been bad. You know what I'm saying? But you know, it is what it is. But yeah, man, that's it. But I talked enough shit today. Tell me, you got anything else to add to this?
I don't know, bro. I don't know how I feel about your statements today.
What do you mean?
You don't think they're true? This girl should be giving out pity love.
Yeah, you don't think that's true though?
I don't know, bro. I don't think so.
Look, Julian's calling. Shall we answer?
Welcome to I'm Down. We are forwarding your call to
you
the
are currently
show.
On the podcast, my guy.
Yo, you have food in your house, man?
Have what? Food?
Yeah, any food and snacks in your house, man? I'm buying here.
Yeah, I do.
Nah, I need food stamps kicked in and, you know, eating good, like, snacks.
Yeah, I tell you, you're on the podcast right now.
All right, that's cool. But I got snacks or not, man. Like, I brought my favorite
one. I got some food, bro. Pull up.
No, I'm so serious. Like, if you don't have any food...
I'm being desperate. I got pan cubano, which is your favorite.
No, first of all, that you hesitated right there. That's a sign of weakness. You hesitated.
Man, I got food, bro.
You promise?
Yes. Come through, you know, talk some shit on the podcast. Actually, so you know what? Come through, because I have a question to ask you, and I think you're a great person to answer this. So at least Chris isn't... Because Chris disagrees with me. I think you might agree with me.
Yo, my neck hurts. Like, I can't go on the podcast. I, like, broke my 50 before.
Who cares? You're good.
Are you gonna carry me back home?
Sure, man. You weigh like 2 pounds. Alright, let's see if he actually pulls up. You don't think that some guys out here need an ego lift?
I agree. I just don't think that guy has to buy ego boost through.
How does a guy get ego lift, not validation from a girl? How else?
That's touche, but still.
Either look, out here in these streets, bro.
I just feel like the girls are like, oh, a guy that. You know? Like, I know it'd be nice if she did. Like, hey, you look great today. And he'd be like, oh, really? You think so? Dang, look at her. She liked me. Cool.
Okay, fine. But, you know, okay.
No.
Okay, fine. Let's get to this point then. Do you think pretty people get too much credit?
Like, credit in what sense?
Like, credit. Like, you think just in general. Like,
yeah. Like, I mean. Like if they had. Like, if they
you
had.
You think it's better to date an ugly chick? Because, okay, look. You know, you hear a lot, right? You hear a lot. That when you go through the struggle, right? When you like struggling through something, you make it out, you know, stronger, better, right? Pretty people don't really have to struggle too much in life. Let's be honest. You know what I mean? The ugly people, you know, you get made fun of in school, all through middle school, all through high school, you get made fun of. You know what I'm saying? Your chances of getting a job aren't, you know, as great as like the pretty girl, right? Or like the super handsome guy. You struggle a little bit. You know what I'm saying? Like you the clothes don't fit you as great. You know what I'm saying? Like. You go through a lot. By the time you're 30, you're a fucking... If you haven't killed yourself yet, you're a fucking warrior at that point. Like, think about that shit. You basically, like... You've withstood high school drama, middle school drama, workplace drama, people, your friends, your family making fun of you, asking you where's your boyfriend at on Thanksgiving or your girlfriend's at Thanksgiving. All the disrespects. Yes. You know, you have that aunt that's like, yeah, you know you? You like, know you? You know what I'm saying?
She's always asking.
Yes. You know, like, listen, I get those questions all the time. You know, like, I'm like, yo.
La amiguita de Jorge?
Yeah, like, yo, that doesn't exist, you know? I mean, you don't think dating an ugly person is, like, better for, like, for anybody? Well, wouldn't you think so? Be honest.
I don't think there's ugly people in the world.
Get the fuck out of here, Chris. Come on. We just had a full-ass fucking conversation about ones and twos. Come on, bro.
I don't know, man. I guess. I depends. Like,
what do you mean you guess? I feel like dating an ugly person.
I think you gotta date somebody who evolved.
What do you mean?
Like somebody who was not the most attractive person.
Okay.
And developed into someone, you know, who's not.
Well, usually those people are the people that end up getting fit, though. Yeah. Like the ugly duckling, right, yeah, in school is like the girl that, like, she went to the gym, she got like a nice body, you know what I'm saying?
That's
she
probably
saying,
like got that, a that's that kind of people you want for a couple of reasons. I think they tend to be not shallow because they remember their roughness.
Right, right.
And they're real. They're like, you know, I know what's up.
Pretty people usually aren't, though. Pretty
people, depending on, like, that's what I'm saying. Like, you want to find somebody who's pretty now.
No, but not everybody is. But not everybody is a pretty.
There's some people who's always been pretty. And that's, like, the unfair, you know?
Wait.
Like, well, they didn't have an ugly stage.
Right.
But, like, you know, like, those dudes that had, like, too many pimples when they were 13. Those girls that...
Right.
That looked like, I don't know, weird, like, weird heads, weird blob-looking bodies. Like,
yeah.
But then turn out, like, yo...
They're
popping. Like, he's a good-looking dude. He's a stud. She's a pretty girl. That's the kind of people you want to date.
I mean, well, if they end up pretty, though. But what if it's just a person who's ugly, just period?
Well, they're ugly. What do you mean? Like, is that...
Because, yo, ugly... Look, there's a thing. Ugly people tend to have the best personalities, if you think about it, right? Yeah. The best
they
humors...
They have to. Well, it's a requirement.
Well, exactly. But it's also a thing of adapting, though, if you think about it.
Yeah, it's a requirement.
I mean, like, look, if you're getting made fun of all the time, right? It's only an amount of time until, like, you start to realize, okay, you know what? If I don't adapt to the situation, right, and get better... And try to build up some humor from this, right? Because, you know, a lot of humor for a lot of comedians is like a defense mechanism. Yeah. If you don't build that up, then you don't really survive.
If I make fun of myself first, then it won't hurt when they make fun of me.
Exactly. You kind of already know what they're going to come with. You get me?
So you get more creative.
Exactly. Yeah. And you become like, you know, your personality is more out there. You know, it's fun. Think about it. How many pretty, real pretty people, you know, that don't really have too much personality? They're dumb. You know, it's like, you don't really want to talk to them.
They don't have a spine.
Exactly. A lot of them be closed-minded. Yeah. They think like everybody else. I was like, get the fuck out of here. You know what I'm saying? You want to hear something different. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, something but it's stupid. Because it's like this vicious circle where pretty people only hang out with pretty people who think the same way. Therefore, they only think the same way.
Exactly. You. I don't know, man. I think that dating somebody ugly could be good. You know what I'm saying? Like, it first of all, it shows
you. So you continue with the idea that maybe we should just try some pettiness out here. And maybe it ends up being good.
Listen, bro. I absolutely, I feel like some of these girls, especially if you're a pretty-ass girl... You have a job in the community to give some of these dudes who aren't really popping some confidence. Why not? Where else are you going to get the confidence from? Where else?
So, like, just tell
me. Because, look, that trickles down. Look, the guy ends up being not too confident, right? He ends up having kids with a not too confident person. The kids end up being not too confident. It trickles down. You know what I'm saying? We want to give some ego.
We want to break the cycle.
Yes. Let's
so, what you're proposing
ego.
Is that, like.
That's where I got my ego. Like, a little bit of ego. I got a little bit of ego.
You should, you should get a girl, like a girl challenge.
No.
You should get a girl challenge where she picks the ugliest guy she knows.
Okay.
And just go on one day. Ask him out on a date.
That's good
for
though.
Coffee. You were asking, like, you know, coffee, tacos, museum.
Yeah.
Ask him out because guess what?
Yeah.
The good-looking person won't know anything in the museum.
Exactly.
The loser boy will know everything in the museum.
Yo,
make it attractive.
You might
you.
Fall in love.
Yeah.
You might fall in love.
So just one time in your life.
Yes.
Date the person you wouldn't date.
Look, the guy who's meant for you is probably been like around you this whole time, and you haven't been paying any attention because he don't look like Brad Pitt or he don't got.
Be careful,
a
George. You about to get DMs, bro.
Who?
You like the guys? Are you
cool? Cool, I answer all my DMs. No problem.
No, they're gonna be like, George, I heard about, you know, the guy's always been around you. I didn't know you felt that way.
Listen, we don't play those kind of games out here, right? But okay, look. Let's put it like this, right? If you're a guy, right, who knows he doesn't really get too much play, where does that guy get some ego from? When I was in middle school, right, when the first, like, week of middle school, three girls came up to me, right? Mind you, middle school, I was pocket size. You know what I'm saying? Right now, I'm like backpack size. You know what I'm saying? But I was pocket, and not even, and not like regular pocket size, cell phone pocket size. You like know that what I'm
small
saying?
One.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Like the Dickie cell phone pocket size. I was about like, you know, maybe 3 feet tall in like sixth grade or something like that. Real skinny kid. Three girls came up to me. Pretty ass girls popping, like, oh my god, you're so cute. Every single time will come up to me saying the same thing. And it wasn't like, you know, like cute as in like, you know, I wanna fuck you. Like, no, not like that. I was like, cute, like you're adorable, you know? That made me feel good. It's like, damn, okay.
Am I right? Am I right?
I never had this feeling in my life before. I never had a group of girls come up to me and tell me, hey, you're a good looking guy.
So you're saying that young girls should do this, not older girls.
Huh? No, it doesn't matter.
Because like the guy is being developed. And, right. You know, nurtured and nurtured at that point.
Well, not so, young girls, because it could be a guy our age today who doesn't have that confidence. Like, do you know a guy right now who you know doesn't really have that much confidence in himself?
Yeah, I don't know about
you,
people.
You do? Okay. You don't think those guys deserve a pretty girl to, like...
No, no, but the problem is a lot of this manifests in the opposite of what you would think.
Why?
Because they act like they think they got confidence. You know, those guys are boast and you know it's because they're lacking confidence. Oh, well,
that's different. You know, those guys don't deserve play either. If you're acting, you have confidence, you don't deserve play. Why are you acting?
Because, you know, like, when someone has confidence, it's not brash. And the guys, there's some guys that are too cocky that you're like, ah, it's because he has no confidence.
But again, like, if you're a guy who has confidence, you don't deserve a girl to, like, play into that. You know what I mean? You need to earn that shit. You know what I mean? If you're a guy who's acting like he has confidence, fuck off. No girl needs to play into that either. You know what I mean? But if a girl knows that, oh, you know, this guy, you know, maybe he needs a little bit of confidence, give it to him. What's wrong with that? I don't see nothing wrong with that. What's wrong with being a little ego into a person?
What's wrong with that? I just feel like it's pitiful. Like, if I was that guy.
You think that guy sees it like that?
I would.
You're saying that because you're a pretty boy. And you think that, oh man, you're saying that in a different point of view. You're looking at the point of view from yourself. Because you're like, if a girl ever gave me pity like that,
yo, I was feel good. Way.
Yeah, but you're a pretty boy though.
I'm not a pretty boy.
If you were a guy who got no girls at all, you don't get girls. That. You will fucking love
I,
that
no,
shit.
I don't
get
the know. Fuck out of
here. See how you want to talk shit now?
I mean, listen, so serious.
If a girl came up to me and be like,
like, hey Chris, you look great. I'll be like, yo, she's fake. She's so fake.
Chris, get the fuck out of here, Chris.
Facts, bro. Being so serious.
You talking shit.
Listen, yo, I don't believe compliments. I don't believe compliments. I'm telling you straight up.
What do you mean you don't believe
compliments? Like, I don't believe, like, a girl compliments dudes or nothing. Like, except, like, I really don't buy into any of that. I'm telling you straight up. Like, I think, like, I would not work. Like, I would feel pitiful if a girl came up to me. Like, I wouldn't know it's pity.
So, so you're saying girls that come up to you and compliment you, you think they're complimenting you for pity?
No. I'm saying, like, if you try to do that whole stunt of, you know, give them that boost he needs. I think that's pitiful.
How would a guy know that,
though? That would make you feel poor, bro. Bad. I don't know.
No. But he doesn't have to know that it's from pity, though.
Nah, but
he doesn't have to reveal that.
Yo, but, like, you know, guys know, bro.
Nah. Guys don't know.
If a girl, nah. A girl comes up to a dude that has never gotten played and starts getting played, you think he's going to buy
it? This right here. Is what happens when you're pretty in society.
Pretty.
This right here is what happens when you're pretty in society.
Pretty.
You take for granted the gifts that God has given you. Yes. Let me tell you something. It will make a person's day. A person's day if a beautiful girl came up to you and complimented you and said, you look good today, and they never get compliments, or they're wishing that they got some type of play and they never got no play. It will make a person's day. You're saying that shit because you're a fucking pretty boy in society. You're used to getting compliments. You know what you are? You're the guy in the office who girls and old ladies compliment you. And there's nothing better than getting compliments from old ladies.
Old ladies are the best.
Getting compliments from old ladies. When you get compliments from old ladies, it's real.
Yeah.
I bet you get compliments from old ladies. You're a fucking pretty boy.
First of all, you old ladies, old ladies
don't fuck around. Let me tell you something right now. If an old lady thinks you're ugly, she ain't giving you the fucking compliment. Old ladies' compliments are real, bro.
There's that old lady at church that told Fatima to her face, if I was your age, I'll snatch him from you.
Exactly. Yo, tying that just...
I did.
Tying the thing up.
I did.
Oh, I think it's like the screw thing. Cause it
I tilt it.
Oh, it is? Oh, you could turn that too. Like, if you... You probably got to loosen it up from the tip.
No, I was tying it. All right, cool. Yeah, man. She told Fatima to her face, eye to eye contact, if I was your age, I'd snatch him from you.
That's real.
That's an old lady, bro.
Old people.
Wild.
When you get old, you no longer give a shit about nothing.
You're like, I'm going to die soon.
Exactly.
Screw it.
At that, so you know it's real. So, listen, you're somebody who's getting old lady compliments. you're a pretty boy in society. First of all,
loser boys get old lady compliments all the time. Nah. You're such a good guy. I don't understand how girls don't see it. No.
You get the compliments that you're handsome, that you're good looking. Those are compliments I'm talking about. Okay, those are real compliments. When there's an old lady who tells you, like she's older, that you're handsome. Old lady told me at work, I got to shave my beard. She's like, yo, it's getting too big. You got to cut it. The thing is that I don't know if I should do that. What do you think? Should shave this beard already?
Like off?
Well, not off. I think she's on like trim it down heavy.
Nah, bro. I told you should go Abraham.
I like it too. Though.
I thought you should go Abraham.
I fuck with it. I don't know, man. You know what?
You're like full decide. Moses. Yeah, pull up a pole.
But you know, but man, listen, man. You're coming from you're speaking from a place of privilege. You're speaking from a place of privilege. I'm telling you. If you didn't get no play like this ever, like ever, you don't want no pity play because you want the real play. You know what real play is. If you never got no play at all, trust me.
You'll take
what you can get.
I don't know.
Yes. I don't know. You go to Vegas with your friends. You have that one guy who gets no play. He gets lucky in Vegas. He's getting the grenade. He's taking the twos. He's taking the threes. He doesn't give a shit. He's taking that. He's taking that down. He's like, yeah, I'm getting something. You get me? Like, come
know,
on, man.
I don't know. Bro. I don't know.
Listen, man. Guys, ladies and gentlemen, this is a man speaking from privilege. You know, there's white privilege. There's pretty boy privilege. That's my whole discussion here. Pretty people get too much credit. You people don't understand.
You people are like, you're an ugly dude right here.
Not that.
I heard about you, homie.
You know, I hate when you say shit like that.
Look at you smile like
mean?
I'm lying.
What does that mean?
Because the streets be talking.
I ain't gonna lie. Let's expand on that conversation real quick. Hey, let me tell you something. I love making Chris sweat sometimes.
I heard about you.
I be asking Chris some questions on the podcast. I told him the other day. He be looking like, yo, Jay, shut the fuck up. Like, please,
sorry,
bro.
Guys. I see you in church.
Listen. I'm just saying, bro. I think that like pretty people, they get way too much credit in society. Life is too easy for them, right? And when you're a below average, I guess, looking person, you know what I'm saying? It just, you have more struggle to go through, and that makes you a better person. That makes you a better person to have conversations with. Like, I want to know how you dealt with bullying. I want to know how you built up this humor. I don't care about you being prom queen and you having, you know, a bad breakup with your athlete boyfriend in high school. I don't care. We hear those stories in the movies all the time. You know, happy endings. We've seen them. We don't see the story of the nerdy kid enough. You know what I mean? Like, we need to see more of them.
We always see it. We see, like, that best friend who was always there and in the end he gets the girl.
No, man. You know what's the problem with Hollywood? Hollywood makes it seem like the girl that's nerdy and ugly is ugly. Like, Princess Diaries, right? She's like an ugly girl. She's not even ugly.
Yeah,
fucked her hair up and gave her big glasses. You got niggas like me thinking she's ugly. Get the fuck out of here. I see right through that shit. I'm like,
Anne Hathaway is beautiful.
Yes.
Bro.
People get girls like Scarlett Johansson that make her the nerdy girl. Get the fuck out of here. Get a real ugly person. You know what I mean? Like Novela back in the day, Betty La Fea, right? That she's like braces
rough,
and
like
shit.
She's rough.
But they make, yo, they try so hard to make these people look ugly.
Well, you can't pick an ugly person because then you can't make them pretty.
No, you can. You can, bro.
You can make them prettier.
Bro, let me tell you something. The reason why a lot of people are deemed ugly, yo, if everybody in the world was fit, like, I'm talking about, like, every guy had a six-pack, every girl had, like, yo, there would be almost no such thing as ugly people if you really think about that. Like,
actually, yeah.
It'll just come down to the face structure. Because there's people that don't have pretty faces, great bodies, and you're getting played. You get me? Because you have a great body. That goes for guys and girls. I mean, at the end of the day, if we played on that scale, it'll be directly bone structure. Like, if your bone structure is not perfect, like, I don't know if you've seen that list that came out recently about, like, what, according to, like, there's, like, a scientific
the
equation.
The symmetry?
Well, no, there's a scientific equation, right, for what makes a person beautiful. And, like, they created a list of, like, the top, like, I don't know, 10 most beautiful people in the world. And one of the, I don't know, Haley Baldwin, one of those Baldwin people, right? Or, like, number one. And Beyonce was, like, number two. And it comes down to, like, bone structure and, like, some Greek bullshit mythology. This is, like, some bullshit thing. You know what I mean? Which, you know, at the end of the day, that's bullshit because it just comes down to, like, who the fuck you think looks good.
Yeah, preferences.
Right. It's all preference. So, whatever the shit was. But, man, listen, bro. Pretty people just have it too easy. Like, okay. If you're a pretty person, right? If you're a very pretty girl, odds of making it on Instagram are like, yo, freaking like right there. Like, you're on the cusp. You know what I mean? If you're a pretty girl, and for you to blow up on Instagram, it's right there. You get 10,000 followers easy. You know what I mean? Put 5 pictures of your booty on Instagram and delete them later, and you still don't have those 10,000 followers. Because it's easy. You know what I mean? Like, pretty people usually have it easier. That's just how it goes down. They don't struggle enough.
We're starting a new hashtag. Ugly people need love too.
Abso-fucking-lutely. Absolutely. Let me tell you something, bro. You fucking talking from privilege, my guy.
Yo.
Yes, you're fucking talking from privilege, bro.
Nah, B.
Get
nah,
the fuck
B.
out
There's
of here.
There's some pictures out there that will show you otherwise.
Like what?
Like those pictures when we were little.
Listen.
I was rough,
Let
bro.
Me tell you something. First I all, remember
if,
those days.
If I post
those, yeah, I was still getting girls.
If I post that picture now.
Let me ask you a question.
Look, if I post those pictures now, I'm getting donations. Somebody okay. is making
yeah,
a link
you
glow, for me.
You gotten better. That's it. Let me ask you a question. In those days, were you still getting some girls?
Yeah.
Were you still getting attention from girls? That's what I mean by getting girls.
Yeah,
but
because...
Yes! Because you... At the, look, how girls look at you today is how they looked at you then. You get me? You just gotten better. They didn't see this Chris. If they were seeing this Chris, and they're like, oh, he's about to look like that, then they're not paying attention to you.
They're waiting for him.
Yes, but they're gonna wait for him, exactly. But they're looking at you like, the same attention you're getting from girls then is the same attention you're getting now. It's probably even more now. You know, you're probably attracting like grown women instead of like girls your age and shit, right? But... It's the same shit. You got it easy, man.
I got it.
It's fucking easy. Yes. You got it easy.
You're an idiot, bro.
Oh, my God. It's the truth. It's the fucking truth. If you don't realize that, you're privileged. You're using privilege. And I think
really
that people...
Privilege.
Listen.
Really privilege.
Look at Charlamagne says that people with white privilege, right, should combat... Should use their white privilege to combat prejudice and, you know, racism, right? Okay. Well, people with pretty privilege, right, should use their privilege... To give the ugly people, you know what I'm saying? To combat some of that.
We're gonna start a campaign. Love the uglies.
Sure, no, man.
Hashtag ugly people need love too.
Ugly people do need love though. They do need love. They do. Yeah, I don't see, listen, man. I don't see nothing wrong with that. If y'all girls see that shit wrong, let me know. Because I don't see nothing wrong with that. I think that that's perfectly fine. There's nothing wrong with that.
Oh, no, man. I just feel like it's horrible.
Okay.
I don't know.
How do you, so what happens with that guy then in society? So he never, how does he get confidence?
He'll adapt.
But how? No, not everybody adapts.
Survival of the fittest.
Survival of the fittest.
Exactly.
So he should die?
No, he adapts.
That's what you're saying.
If he adapts.
What if he doesn't?
Then that's it. That's life.
No, he dies.
What about the ugly duckling who doesn't get a couple?
What do you mean?
Like,
do you even know the story of the ugly duckling?
No, clearly not.
Clearly. Doesn't the ugly duckling end up being like a prince or something like that? Like, or I'm thinking about Princess and the Frog, right? Right, I'm thinking about Princess and the Frog.
That's the one with the she kisses the frog, right?
Yeah. Wait, so what's the ugly duckling story? Doesn't the ugly duckling turn into a swan or something?
Yeah,
like
he becomes famous or whatever.
Okay,
know. You
know why? Because there was a
different.
Swan who gave him attention.
He was different. No, that's
no
not
man,
good.
a swan came and gave him attention.
Somebody proof check our Disney knowledge.
Check me right now in the comments. I'm pretty sure a swan came and gave him some attention and he flourished. Sometimes guys need a girl to come through and build them up.
It's because he was an ugly duckling because he was meant to be a swan.
What?
That's what it is.
What do you mean?
Like, he was always an ugly duckling because he was never meant to be a duck. He was meant to be a swan. So he didn't fit into what people thought he was. He fit into who he was supposed to be. That's the whole idea of that.
How did he end up fitting into that then?
Because when he grew up, they realized he was never a duck. They just always thought he was an ugly duckling. That's why he looked a certain way, but he was never a duck. So
what was he? He was a swan?
Yeah, or something
but
like that.
But swans are beautiful.
That's my point. But when you compare it to a duck... And you think everybody else is a duck.
So the ducks thought he was ugly, but he was really a swan.
Exactly.
But then he turned into a swan.
So they finally realized, he was never meant to be a duck.
Oh, so for a duck, he looked ugly.
Yeah.
So ducks are prejudiced to swans. Because to ducks, it's like, that's what you're saying. So ducks look at swans. Like,
what
God,
I'm
these
saying
are ugly
is,
ass birds.
When you compare somebody to who they're not supposed to be,
okay,
they will never be good enough. But when you compare it to who they're supposed to be, they will always be beautiful.
But, okay.
So, there's no ugly people, George.
No,
there's a person who belongs in Silicon Valley.
Of
and
course.
There's a person who belongs in Vogue.
But we're talking about more general consensus, right? We're talking about the unpopular guy in high school. We're talking about those type
of
people.
He'll make it to Silicon Valley and own everything.
What
it's
if
cool.
he does it, though?
And then money makes you attractive.
Some of them stay in The Office.
Money makes you attractive.
Yeah, but some of them stay in The Office.
There's
not
ugly rich
smart.
People.
Yes, but not all of them are smart. Not all of them make it.
Darwinism.
Work, what,
Darwinism.
I don't know what that is.
Survivor is the fittest.
That's what that is. Okay, but what happens? Survival of the fittest. If you don't ever, cut the line, what happens? You die off.
Some DNAs have to end off.
No, man.
Let's kill off that ugly gene.
Listen. We need to give because there's a thing. Now, if you give this guy an ego boost and he still fails, then fuck that. You know, you tried.
You tried your
best. Yeah, you tried. But so, we gotta try.
You think we should promote
power.
Social warfare, welfare towards pretty people?
Think about it. What girls are so beautiful, right? What do you use your pretty for? For what? What are you doing? Like, what are you doing for the community? Using, what are you doing? What do you do for the community?
We should have social welfare for the ugly people.
Yes. No, but it's not social welfare. You get me?
Like for the well-being.
Because social welfare is not like a government thing where like now it's like, yo, we're going to take pretty girls and give it to you. Nah, that's fucked up. That's like a form of slavery. I'm just saying, I think pretty girls, right, need to take time off, take this as like an opportunity, you get me, to do some good in the world.
To give back.
Yes. Yo, you're blessed with pretty looks. Why not go and give a guy, a nerdy guy, some compliments? Have coffee with him. Why not? Go talk to somebody different. Stop talking to all these fucking pretty guys. These pretty guys all say the same shit. Think about that. Think about that shit. What are you talking? Like, when's the last time you learned something from a pretty guy?
I don't know. I don't talk to pretty people.
Huh?
I don't talk to pretty people.
Oh, you don't talk to pretty people now? Okay.
No, I never said I did.
Okay. You know what, Chris? I'm sick of your shit, man. I'm sick of your shit, man. Julian ain't even pull up. Let me see, man. Nah, man, he's not gonna pull up. I'll call him one more time. See,
you're wild.
I think Julian has good perspectives
on this stupidity. Is what you mean?
No, it's not stupidity, man. Yo, you know what? I'm telling you right now. I know some people are gonna agree. Some people are gonna disagree. Look, this is all I ask everybody. I just ask everybody to, you know, look at this with an open mind. You know what I'm saying?
To not just knock it down.
Yes, don't knock it. Look at it with an open mind. You know what I'm saying? We can agree to disagree. You know what I'm saying? And we see.
We start a new hashtag.
Yeah. See this guy answers.
Ugly people need love too, guys.
We can wrap this up. Let's see. No, all right. I'm going to call that a bitch. I mean, you got anything else to add to this?
I don't know. I think you nailed it on the.
So we agree to disagree.
On the stupidity of the head.
I think that's pretty good, man. I think that's
I would love to hear a girl say, you know what? I agree with you, George. I'm going to be nicer to ugly people.
Trust me, when I take this clip out, somebody's going to say something. You get me? Yo.
What you want?
Where are you? We're doing the podcast and we're freaking waiting for you. You're not here.
I'm in the shower, you bastard.
For what?
You got pulled from the park.
Are you going to pull up or no? Okay, fine. We'll wait for you for episode 2 if Chris is not too busy. Oh, this nigga hung up. All right, but you know, people, leave down in the comments, you know what I'm saying, whether this is on IGTV, Instagram. By the way, we've been getting some pretty good traction on TikTok.
I
want to say good traction, like in the super positive way, but you know, it's more alarming stuff. It's very some creeps there.
Really?
I got another creep message, but it's okay. I ignore those.
I thought TikTok was like for little kids.
Well, that's exactly the best you gotta be. You know, you gotta.
No, but I'm saying, but what the creeps are there? Just being rapists.
Yeah. They're like the weird usernames and like leaving creepy messages, like oh, you still look good as ever. We got another message
because
like
they didn't get complimented with the pretty girls when they were young.
Maybe, who knows? But you know, hey, you gotta be where the kids are at. Sometimes if the kids are on TikTok, maybe you reach
we
some
jump
kids
on,
to TikTok.
We jump on, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You gotta do what you gotta do. So
again, just don't be weird about it.
Again, you know, this is I'm down. If you thought what we said was dumb, if you thought what we said was stupid, if you thought what we said was ingenious, if you thought what we said was daunting, you're right. If you thought what we said was smart, if you thought what we said was uplifting, if you thought what we said made you want to go and do something, this is I'm fucking down. Thank you for watching. Till next time.